Hello friends, Doug Fink, Microsoft MVP. In this video, I'm going to show you how OpenAI meets PowerShell, and I'm going to build an autonomous agent. Make it so. I'm going to use this YouTubeScraping.psm1, and what it has is several functions in it that you can walk up to it with a video ID, and it will reach out to that video and pull down the transcript. Every time you upload a video to YouTube, YouTube will actually transcribe it, take what you say and put it all into text. You can find that under the YouTube description. There's a transcript button, and then you can see the transcript. So if I wanted to go and do that, get that information, I can go to the video, I can copy paste, but you know, we're talking about PowerShell and automation and AI, so there's got to be a better way. So first up, I'm going to take this YouTube ID. It's a video I did about using PowerShell and AI to build an explain function. You can check that out at another time. So I'm going to just take that video ID. There's a function called get transcript inside of YouTube scraping with a bunch of other supporting functions that do a bunch of things to make sure it gets to the right page and does a bunch of scraping, so on and so forth. So if I run this, let's see what happens. Goes up, grabs it, and it grabs the full transcript, pulls back when it's that particular part started, the duration, and this is YouTube's transcription of the video of what I talked about, and that's all well and good. Now, if I wanted to, I could also, there's other ways you can get videos, right? You can grab, if you do a right mouse click and say copy URL, you get the entire URL. Now if I run this using that full URL on a different video, it'll come back and says it can't find it. Why? Because the get transcript doesn't recognize and parse the full URL. It only takes the video ID. So now I could actually sit here and take this and either copy paste the video ID and then pop it in, or I can write, you know, I could write a piece of code for that, or I could update the get transcript to do that, but I don't feel like it. The other thing is, what if I wanted to look at two videos, right? If I said comma video ID 2 and 3, well, unfortunately the get transcript only handles one video at a time, so that means I would have to set that up outside as a list of video IDs, and then I would have to do a for loop and then call get transcript each time. Doable, not too much work, but hey, I think there's a better way. All right, so now we know how we can get a transcript from any YouTube video using PowerShell. What I want to do now is create an agent. So I have a module called PS AI Agent, and now what I can do, this depends on my PS AI implementation, which is the OpenAI SDK, to talk to their back end. And I can say something like new agent, all simple and good. Now, here's the real magic sauce. It can take tools, and the way you do a tool, you create a tool, is you say register, and you give it the name of the function, and you can do more than one function, but here we're just gonna do get transcript. And what happens is the register tool actually looks at this function, figures out, take a look at that over here. So this is a simple function, right? It's just the name of a function, and it takes one parameter. And what register tool does is it figures out this signature, the name of the function, all the parameters, the types of parameters, and it translates it into a JSON format that OpenAI function calling expects, so that it can become part of how OpenAI can then take a prompt and then from the prompt figure out what external tools you've passed to it, so that it can then give you, the programmer or the scripter, a list of functions to call based on the prompt. So OpenAI doesn't actually do the calling of the external tool, you do that, but this is all wrapped up inside of something called New Agent that handles all that for you. So you don't have to worry about OpenAI actually calling these functions willy-nilly. You get to control what gets called, what and how it gets called. So this is a pretty simple, straightforward thing. So we're gonna just take dollar agent, we add the tool to it, and now what we're going to do is we are going to say, okay, agent, we want to get an agent response. So we're going to take that agent, pass it into agent response, also part of the PSAI agent module. And here we're going to do give it a prompt. And I want to say something like summarize and the video transcript. And I'm just going to give it the ID. And I'm just going to say, take this all out. Say, summarize that. Okay. Let's see what it does. And what you can do is you can turn on something called show tool calls. So let's run that. And hopefully we'll see that it. Yep. So that's it telling me what to call. And then underneath it does call it. And it gets the transcript. And here is the summarization of that transcript I initially showed you using straight, just a plain vanilla get transcript. But now we've taken that. It told us what to call. We called get transcript. It provided the proper video ID. And then we passed the results of the get transcript back to OpenAI, asking it to summarize it. That's pretty cool. Now, let's take it a little further. Instead of giving us some sentences, I want to say three bullets. Did I get that right? And oh, yep. Let's do a dash. Three bullets. 10 words each. So now I'm asking AI to do it again. And when it summarizes, I do three bullets and each one should be 10 words. So now I've just summarized that video, which was about 4 minutes long. And this is what it came up with as a summarization. Pretty cool. But let's gonna take it further. Let's say I wanted to also get, right, if I had the another video, right, we showed the URL. Now remember, the get transcript doesn't know how to parse and take apart a URL and just grab the ID. So now I'm just going to put this part of the prompt. I'm just going to give it an ID and I'm going to give it a URL. Let's see what it does. So now AI, very cool. Oops, I guess there we go. So AI actually figured out that the second one was in fact a YouTube video, and it extracted itself on its own and extracted that video ID, and then it also said, hey, you gotta go call get transcript twice, and here are the two different ones, two separate calls. And I didn't have to build the loop, I didn't have to build the parsing, and here we come back and we see that it summarizes each video. So I just want to take you through that. So this is the building an autonomous agent. The autonomous part is that it, the more videos you give it, whether it's an ID or whatnot, and if you give it you can put an ID in there that's different and wrong, it won't check it for that. That's get transcript will come back and say, hey, couldn't find a caption. And what's really cool is if it can't find a caption and whatnot on YouTube, it'll hand that back to AI as part of the discussion, and then AI will say, hey, we tried to look this up, but we didn't get any results. So there's no erroring in that sense, and you get that kind of summarization even if things are not found. So all you got to do is when you use the new module is you register existing functions that you already have, and now they become part of agents, and this begins to take on a whole different set of capabilities. Hope you liked the video. More to come. We're only just at the starting line. Data, take us out of orbit.